Not too long ago, I made a video covering supplements I believe was not worth the money, especially in the case of building muscle. Much to the chagrin of avid supporters, I included HMB as part of that list. Of course, not everyone agreed with my reasoning and offered their anecdotes showing its effectiveness. Fortunately, a new HMB meta-analysis has sprouted that sheds some more light on the matter and might finally give us a more decisive answer. Let's take a closer look. In this meta-analysis, the researchers looked at randomized control trials on HMB supplementation. They ended up with 6 studies after weeding out low quality and publication biases, totaling 193 subjects between the ages of 19 and 26. On average, subjects had about 5 years of training experience, not too far off from the typical gym goer, if not just a tad more. The studies outlined HMB's effects on fitness-related factors including strength and overall body composition. So what were the results? The effect size, or the quantification of the strength of any given effect, of HMB to a placebo tends to show that HMB isn't all that great. Looking at strength-based factors such as bench press, show effect size means hovering close to the middle, indicating HMB being no better than a placebo. Much remains the same when we look at leg press strength, with even some deviating towards HMB having a negative effect. Nonetheless, it still sits close to zero with all things considered. When we look at body composition, again, we see the same thing. HMB on overall body mass did not deviate far from a placebo. Same for overall fat-free mass, with some showing positive effects, but insignificant. And finally, in terms of fat mass, some findings trend towards a negative effect, but again, insignificant altogether. It looks like the overall effect just isn't there, especially for trained individuals. The thing is, a 2009 meta-analysis had already showed similar findings to this 2017 review, concluding that both strength and fat-free mass benefits from HMB were trivial in trained men with a slight potential benefit for untrained men. However, a 2015 meta-analysis again brought uncertainty when they concluded that pairing HMB with resistance training prevented the loss of lean mass in older adults. Also, the 2017 analysis was not without limitations. There weren't that many randomized control studies, not a lot on women, and each study had wide-ranging differences in training protocols, not all of which catered directly to changes of strength and body composition. For that reason, the authors closed out with this statement: HMB supplementation does not have a significant effect on improving strength or body composition in trained and competitive athletes. However, due to differences in the studies, it is difficult to draw a definite conclusion. Even though we don't have a clear answer, such as the case for science, we are drawing much closer to realizing that HMB isn't the magical supplement it was once touted. If you ask me, it's still not worth your money, and you're best served on other supplements, such as creatine. But if you do decide to take it anyway, just make sure you temper your expectations. With less than a week left before the end of the very first PictureFit giveaway, come sign up today for a chance to win a set of Liebert Equalizer bars, perfect for in-home training. Share your thoughts on the new research below, and as always, thank you for watching and get your protein.